Hi there! In this video, we'll go over the steps to import sales and purchase orders to Inflow. Before we continue, we recommend adding pricing and taxing schemes to Inflow first. Check out the pricing and taxes video for complete steps. Let's start by making the CSV. Like in previous videos, you can export from Inflow as a shortcut for creating a CSV template. In Inflow, click on Main Menu, then Export. Select Sales Orders. If you don't have orders in Inflow, you can ignore the Order Date Range drop-down menu. If you do have orders, select one of the date options so you can view how existing orders look in CSV format. Click Export and save the CSV to your computer. Repeat the previous steps to create a purchase order export file. Open one of the CSVs you downloaded from Inflow. In this example, you can see one sales order that was exported that we can reference while we add data to this template. Inflow can import orders as either open, which means awaiting fulfillment, or completed and fulfilled. If you have a mix of open and completed orders you want to import to Inflow, we suggest making two templates, one for open orders and one for completed orders. Let's start by making a sales order template with completed orders. The first column is the order number column. This field is optional, and if you don't fill it out, Inflow will create order numbers for you. Speaking of optional fields, if the template has more fields than you need, feel free to remove them from the CSV. Inventory status could be either unfulfilled for open orders or fulfilled for completed orders. The payment status column is where you can track what stage of payment the sales order is in. Enter invoiced if you sent the customer the sales order invoice, or uninvoiced if the invoice hasn't been sent to the customer. Next, add your customer's name. This field is a required field, which means it must be filled out for Inflow to import sales orders. If you speak with a specific rep when dealing with your customer, you can enter their name in the contact name column. Next, use the phone and email fields if you have your customer's contact information. Enter the date the order was created in the order date column. If you leave this blank, Inflow will use the date of import as the order date. You can use the freight field for tracking shipping fees on the sales order. The invoice date is the date your customer was sent an invoice for the sales order. This can be the same date as the order date, or it could be different. The due date is used for tracking when your customer's payment is due. If the sales order has been paid, you can enter the date you received payments in the Date Paid field. The Amount Paid column is where you can track how much the customer has paid on the sales order. You can enter the full or partial amounts here. The Location column is where you can track the place of the order fulfillment. This should be set to a main location, such as a building, and not an aisle or bin. If you have the payment information, you can fill out the pricing scheme, payment terms, payment method, and taxing information. Towards the end of the CSV, you'll see the fields for the product information. Enter the product name, SKU, description, quantity, and pricing information. Each row on the CSV can only import one product at a time. This is shown in the exported sales order above. For sales orders that have multiple products on the same order, copy and paste the row you just filled out and change the product fields for the additional products that are on the same sales order. As a reminder, there might be more fields on the CSV exported from Inflow than what you need. You can remove any of these fields to save time. If you sell products with serial numbers, create one row on the CSV per serial number. For example, on a regular product, you can enter two in the product quantity field. But for serialized products, you can only enter one in the product quantity field. Following that, you'll need to enter the specific serial number for that product in the product serials field. This means if you sold three serialized products on a single order, you'll need to create three rows on the CSV to track all three unique serial numbers. Towards the end of the template is the IsQuote column. This is where you can make a sales order into a sales quote. To make a sales order a quote, enter true in the field. Enter false if you want it to remain as a sales order. If you don't have any sales quotes, you can omit filling out this column altogether, and when you import, Inflow will assume you're importing sales orders. Is canceled is the last column on the CSV template. This is where you can import the order to Inflow as a canceled order. This is helpful if your team tracks all orders that have been made but won't be fulfilled. Enter true if you want to import the sales order as canceled, and false if you want to import the sales order normally. Canceled orders are hidden in Inflow by default, but at any time you can find canceled orders from the order list. At the top of the page, click on the All View option. Click on Status, Canceled, then click Apply. You'll see a list of your canceled orders below. Now back to the CSV. You can ignore this field if you don't plan to import any orders as canceled. When done, save the spreadsheet as a CSV file. To create a purchase order CSV template, follow the previous steps. We recommend exporting a CSV from Inflow and filling out all the fields on the CSV, just like what we did with sales orders. The fields are very similar. Let's go back to Inflow to import. Click on Main Menu, then Import. Select Sales Order from the Data Type drop-down menu. Below, select the CSV file from your computer, then click Next. At the top of the page, you'll see the Import Orders As setting. Select one of the options. In this example, we'll be importing completed orders. Below, you'll see a preview of what Inflow is reading from your CSV file. If you only see a preview without any fields below, select Edit Data Mapping. Match the Inflow fields to the CSV fields in the drop-down menus. When importing a CSV file that was exported from Inflow, a lot of the fields will be matched for you, but it's always a good idea to review the fields to make sure everything is correct. When done, click Import. You'll now see an Import is in Progress message. Click OK. You'll get an email with the results when the import is done. Repeat the import steps if you're importing open sales orders or open or completed purchase orders. And that's how you can import sales and purchase orders. If you have any questions, reach out to the Inflow team. Thanks for watching!